How are you all? Hope you all are fine. Good morning, and I welcome you in Sri G. M. Londa Primary School in English Grammar Session, Chapter Number 8, Pronouns. Now, children, you already know we have studied in the previous classes about pronoun. Yes. So, pronoun is a word used in place of a noun. Yes. So, here the definition is, a pronoun is a word used in place of a noun. We can take examples like, Ankur was angry with Sangeeta. Okay. So, here we can put in place of Ankur. Yes, he was angry with Sangeeta. So we have used he instead of Ankur. So that is called pronoun. Or we can say Ankur was angry with Sangeeta. He said that she should not have tasted the dog. Here, now we in this sentence we can say he stands for Ankur. Yes. And she stands for Sangeeta. The words Ankur and Sangeeta are nouns. Therefore, the words he and she are pronouns. Got it, my children? Now, we are going to study kinds of pronouns. Okay. So, there are 8 categories of pronouns. That is, personal pronoun, demonstrative pronouns, interrogative pronouns, reflexive pronouns, emphasizing pronouns, possessive pronouns, relative pronouns, and indefinite pronouns. Okay, so first we will study about personal pronoun. Here, personal pronouns represent specific people or things. We use them depending on number, that is singular one, or plural, that is we. Person, first person, I, second person, you, or third person, he. Gender, male, he, female, she, or neuter, it. Case, subject, we, or object, us. In short, the definition is, a pronoun that stands for a person or a thing is called a personal pronoun. So, 3 persons are there. Yes, first person, second person, and third person. Fine. The first person is the person speaking. The second person is the person spoken to. And the third person is the person spoken about. If I speak to you, for example, if I speak to you about Vijay, I am the first person. You are the second person and Vijay is the third person. So, we use personal pronouns in place of the person or people that we are talking about. Now, here is a table. Okay, there numbers are given, singular and plural. Person, first, second, third. In plural, first, second, third. Gender, male, female. There you have to use subject, I, and object, me. Second, male or female. Subject, you or you. In third person, male, female, neuter. Subject, he, she, it. An object, him, her, it. Plural, first, second, third. Male or female, we, us. Second, male, female, you, you. Third, male, female or neuter, they, them. You should talk to Renu. She needs your help. Yes. So, here both Renu and she is singular number and feminine gender. Understood? Now, possessive pronouns. We use possessive pronouns to refer to a specific person, people or thing belonging to the person or people. Okay, so here you will never find a possessive pronoun near a noun, despite the fact is the genitive or personal pronoun. We use possessive pronoun depending on the number, singular mind or plural us. Person first, person mine, second person yours, or third person his. Gender male, his, female, hers. So, in short, the definition of possessive pronoun is a pronoun that shows possession is called a possessive pronoun. Now, below the possessive pronouns followed by some example sentences, each possessive pronoun can be subject or object, refer to a singular or plural antecedent. So these things you have to remember, children. Now, used before nouns, used alone. Your singular, my, your, his, her, its. Plural, I, your, their. Used alone, mine, yours, his, hers, its, us, yours, theirs. Now your example, this is not my pen, mine is new. So in this sentence, my is used as possessive adjective. Yes, in the second sentence, the word mine stands for my pen, so it is used as a pronoun. Reflexive pronoun. So, definition of reflexive pronoun is, reflexive pronoun is used with the active voice verb in order to reflect the action of the verb back on the subject, the antecedent. Now, emphatic pronoun accompanies its antecedent in order to accentuate its action state. Reflexive and emphatic pronouns take different positions within the sentence structure. So, in short, pronouns like myself, yourself, himself, when used as the receiver of an action, are called reflexive pronoun. And a pronoun used to convey emphasis is called an emphasizing pronoun. So, we use a reflexive pronoun when we want to refer back to the subject of the sentence or clause. Reflexive pronouns end in self, singular, or selves, plural. There are 8 reflexive pronouns. So, here are some examples. I blame myself. For my failure, and I myself locked it. So, here I myself locked it is emphasizing pronoun. I blame myself for my failure is reflexive pronoun. Because how? Because I blame myself. So, blamed whom? Myself. So, the word myself has been used as a reflexive pronoun. Okay. So, and I myself locked it. Your question. Okay. Whom? And emphasizing pronoun. Demonstrative pronoun. So, demonstrative pronouns and demonstrative adjectives have exactly the same forms. The ways to differentiate them depends on their position relative to the antecedent determined nouns. Now, examples. This tastes good. These are bad times. That is beautiful. Those were the days. So the pointing are demo these, that, those are demonstrative pronouns, interrogative pronouns. Now we use interrogative pronouns to ask questions. The interrogative pronoun represents the thing that we don't know. These are four main interrogative pronouns: whom, who, whom, what, which. Okay, the possessive pronoun whose can also be an interrogative pronoun. So in short, an interrogative pronoun is used to ask a question. For example, what is your plan? Which train is late? Now relative pronoun. A relative pronoun is a pronoun that introduces a relative clause. It is called a relative pronoun because it relates to the word that it modifies. Okay, so here, in short, a relative pronoun relates a noun to a group of words that follow. Here are some examples. Where is the man who gave you this news? Okay, and this is the book which you have been looking for. Here are the colors that you wanted. So in this sentence, the words who, which, and that have been used as relative pronouns. They relate a noun to the group of words that follow the nouns. Indefinite pronouns. An indefinite pronoun does not refer to any specific person, thing, or amount. It is vague and not definite. Some typical indefinite pronouns are here. In this chart, it's given, children. So learn it. Some indefinite pronouns, singular and plural, another, everybody, no one, both. So like that. And he has one job in the day and another at night. So another is pronoun. I did like another drink, please. That is adjective. So children, so hope you have understood. Learn the chapter thoroughly. The rules and forms are given in your textbook. Okay, so learn it properly. And till then, bye bye. Stay safe and thank you, children.